Students, good morning. Welcome to English class. So I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, in our previous class we have done module 5, and under this module 5 we did the section grammar. So under this grammar section, what did we discuss? Yes, we discussed adjective describing words. So adjectives are also called as describing words, the words that describes the noun, that describes a person, that describes the animal or etc. So I hope you understood it. So today in this class we are going to do the another section from module 5, that is I write. So what are the things that we are going to discuss in this section? Yes, number 1, parts of story, and number 2, paragraph writing. So now let us move towards the learning outcomes of today's class. Now the learning outcomes are, number 1, enable the students to learn about the parts of story and how to write it effectively. And secondly, the students will be learning about paragraph writing and understand how it is helpful. So we will be learning about the parts of story and also the paragraph writing and its helpfulness. How does it help? So let us move forward. Now parts of story. Now what is this parts of story? A story has 3 main parts. So students, we all listen to stories. It is very interesting, is not it? We listen to different kind of stories. You also listen to different kind of stories. Now the story actually, it is having 3 main parts. So what are the main parts of story? Number 1, the beginning. So whenever we write a story, in the beginning we have something. Number 1, beginning. So what is that beginning actually? This is the first paragraph of the story. It tells us who the main characters in the story are. It also tells us where the story is taking place. So in the first paragraph, the beginning, we learn about the story. That is, the thing is that we learn about the main characters of the story. Who are the main character of the story? Who will be playing the roles, different roles during the entire story? And it also tells us where the story is taking place. That means the situation, the environment, and the particular place where the story takes place. If it is a house, if it is a forest, if it is the like a palace or wherever it is, so it tells us about that. Now the next one is the middle. So in the middle part, what did we do? In the middle part, we get, this is where the actual event of the story are told. So in the middle part, during this part, in that particular part, the main event, the main happenings of the story takes place. So whatever happens in the story, what is the climax of the story? Generally, in the middle part of the story, these things are described. And finally, the end. So the ending of the story, what do we get? This is the last paragraph of the story. It explains the story finishes, and it also explains the values or morals of the story. That means by the end of the story, what we get, it explains how the story finishes. After the middle part, whenever all the situations that happens, the main events of the story happens, and finally in the end, how does the story ends, we get that, and we also get the moral of that particular story. So this is all about the parts of the story. So what do we learn? Yes, a story has generally 3 main parts: the beginning, the middle, and the end. I hope you have understood it. Now let us move towards exercise 4.1. So what is given here? The beginning, the middle, and the end of the story are mixed up. Identify each part of the story and rewrite it below. Now here in the story, you can see there are 3 parts are given. Number, beginning, middle, and end. But it is not given properly. It is given in an unsystematic way. So we have to make it systematic, and we have to first identify and rewrite the story again. So now let us read this one. He asks them to come to him the next day. He asks them to fill the room with something. He says that whatever does it will become the next king. The first son brings diamonds. The second son fills the room with cotton. The third keeps a lamp in the middle of the room. It spreads light in the whole room. The king is happy with his third son. He decides to make him the new king because his third son is the wisest of the 3. And finally, in the last, it has been given, a king is going to die. He is lying in his bed. in his castle before dying, he wants to test his three sons. So from those three headings, we have these three past paragraphs, we have come to know, we have to identify, yes, what, which will be the beginning, which will be the middle, and which will be the end. So dear students, I want you to do this one by yourself. So in your English copy, you will be doing this one. Okay, first you will be writing this question, then you will write number one, the beginning, then you will write which one will be coming in the beginning, then you will write the paragraph, after that you will be writing the middle, then you will write the middle part and the end. Okay, I hope you will be able to do it, and it is very interesting also. Now let us come towards the paragraph writing. Actually, what is this? We often on we are saying paragraph. So what is this paragraph actually? A paragraph is a group of sentences about the same topic. Learning how to write a paragraph can be helpful. So a paragraph is a group of sentences about the same topic. For example, a topic has been given like the cow or the tiger, and we are asked to write about it. So what we will do? We will be writing many things about that particular animal. So we will be writing it like this. So it is a paragraph, and we will be writing on the same topic. Same topic, for example, a paragraph has been given for the cow. So on the cow, we will be writing a paragraph. Learning how to write a paragraph can be helpful. So, and lining, we will also learning how it is helpful for us. So this is all about paragraph writing. Now in this exercise 4.2, what has been given? Let us see. Complete this paragraph about your summer vacation. Write what you liked the most and what you did during your vacation. Use the hints to complete your paragraph in 5 lines. So below you can see some of the hints are there for us, and you can see in this picture some of the pictures and some of the sentences are given in different colorful circles. So what we have to do, we have to observe this picture nicely, and then after that we have to use those given words in these different colorful boxes, circles, and write it below. So let us read this one. Went to a new place, read story books, played games, go for a summer camp, and learn to swim. Now it has been given down. Let us read this one. This year I dash during this summer vacation. I spent my days dash. I learned dash. I like dash. Next year I want to dash during my summer vacation. So dear students, I want you to do this one also and try it by yourself. If I tell you the answer, then it will not do. So the thing is that you try to write down it, then only I will understand that yes, you have understood the meaning of paragraph writing, and then you will be able to do this one properly. So dear students, I hope that you have understood it well, and you can write a beautiful paragraph. Now let us come to the summary of today's class. What we learned? What have we learned? So what have we learned? Number one, we have learned about the parts of story. A story has three parts mainly. Number one is the beginning, number two is the middle, and number three is the end. And finally, we have also learned about the paragraph writing. And what is this paragraph? Paragraph is a group of sentences about the same topic. So dear students, with this I hope that you have understood the rules of story writing, the parts of story writing, and the way to write a paragraph also. So please learn it and do the given works properly by yourself. Okay, so with this we have come to the end of today's class. Thank you and have a nice day.